All right, guys, so I've been getting some requests to cover Between the Buried and Me. This is not a band I wanted to cover. One of my biggest issues with this band is that they make music that is meant to be enjoyed ironically. And when you do that, you are already ruining your music's chance at being appreciated in any objective way. If you're trying to be clever with your genre mixing and have the entire concept of your band be, oh, what are they gonna do next? What curveball are they gonna throw at me? How kitschy is it gonna be? How entertaining, how funny is it gonna be? You've already kind of ruined your chance of being a serious artist. I mean, they're fantastic musicians. Don't get me wrong. I mean, every band I cover on here is gonna be full of fantastic musicians. Everyone's a fantastic musician now. Just fucking go on YouTube, learn to play something. It's not hard. But aside from all that, it's just, why should I take it seriously? Why should I take them seriously when their music is not meant to be taken seriously and their fans are appreciating them on only an ironic level? And they'll never admit that. You know, people are gonna love this band because of the musicality behind it. At the heart of it, this is still a metalcore band, no matter how much they dress it up. I remember when they came to prominence, they started with a band called Prayer for Cleansing, I think. I've been involved in the Milwaukee music scene for a long time, and metalcore had this city in its like death grip for the early aughts. And when Between the Buried and Me became a thing, it was fucking huge. Everybody loved it. And one thing to note about metalcore fans is they're really good pretenders. Like, you remember that band Caven? They put out that Until Your Heart Stops record. Everybody loved it. It's kind of like a coalesce type of thing. Everybody loved it in the metalcore scene. Then they put out Jupiter, and metalcore fans pretended to like Jupiter. Not because they wanted to admit they enjoyed the music, but they wanted their friends to think that they enjoyed the music, for to give this illusion of depth. And I think that's what's going on with a band like this. You know, when they throw all those curveballs at you, you're held hostage by the idea that you're gonna be getting that breakdown to make you remember that you're still listening to a metalcore band and you're there for that breakdown. But all that shit they do beforehand, you know, all the genre mixing and all the hilarious little passages that they throw at you beforehand, that's there to make that breakdown more important, because, you know, it's all these segues that really don't actually contribute to what the band really represents, which is that heavy nature of that primal breakdown. And it's, you have to have it. You have to have it to maintain the fan base that they have. And, you know, let's talk about, I don't want to draw too many comparisons before I watch the video, but this band reminds me of like Family Guy, the show Family Guy, where it's at its heart, it's entertaining, you know. You can put it on and get lost for like 26 minutes or whatever, and it'll make you laugh, but it's completely nonsensical. And it's not meant to be taken seriously. It's not meant to be looked at as a well-written show. And this is not meant to be looked at as well-written music. It's meant to be looked at as a bag full of party tricks that is just spilt out onto the carpet for you to trip on. And it shouldn't be viewed as anything more than that, aside from maybe talking about how great the musicians are at their instruments. But I'm gonna stop talking about my opinions of the band. We'll go into this song with a fresh palate, see how it goes. All right, five count. It's Prague. It's got to be Prague. Five count.
Thank you.
So prior to the vocals, you could pick up on a lot of those like 80s passages, like that little, like that high clean guitar break. You can, that'll jog to memory, like, you know, hits from the 80s. And I know that this song is, its attempt is to show you that a lot of those kitschy elements of 80s music that are present in their progressive genre that they've somehow attached themselves to, that it's still part of who they are. But I don't believe it is. I think that it's them just kind of having fun with the idea that there were bands before them in the progressive genre that did these silly things. This is still a metalcore band. They're not what they're pretending to be on stage. So what we're hearing now, you know, not the worst transition in the world. It still required like a lot of overbooking to make these two passages work together. But they're really trying to get across to you that like Porcupine Tree by way of metalcore thing. You know, it's rooted in that groove. You still have that hi-hat going on, but the stuff they're doing over it is meant to appeal to that kind of ethereal progressive fan. But as long as you have that rhythmic backbone, you'll keep your metalcore fan base satiated. So they really just want to hammer in that this is an homage to 80s cliches thing. You got your Yes passage with those orchestra hits, and then you've got your Ferris Bueller Oh Yeah sample. I mean, this is the kind of stuff I'm talking about, where part of me wants to like this band. They're really talented, and they can create a compelling melody. A lot of progressive bands, can't construct a compelling melody. I know these guys are capable of it, but they're so insistent on making their music ironically enjoyable that it's just like, you know, I'm going to give it a passing glance here and there, but I'm not going to be able to actually internalize this as true art in any way. It's just something that's entertaining. It's an episode of Family Guy. All right, well, let's keep going. And if you note, they wanted to tie the part before it into the verse riff again, and instead of coming up with something that actually works, they just threw in all of these samples to make you remember the 80s. You know, it's pretty cheap. The metalcore is starting to come out. I told you'd be here. It's coming.
Yes,
So, you know, we have a pretty pretty convincing thrash segment here, but the rest of that shit is so goddamn silly. Like, how am I supposed to take this seriously as an actual aggressive passage? Get ready, here comes a fucking breakdown, guys. You ready? Here it fucking comes! See, fuck this band. This is what I'm talking about right here. They come across as if they have this huge presentation of being a real progressive band. They hit you with silly cliche after silly cliche, and then they give you the fucking breakdown so that all you metalcore fans that are pretending to like progressive music are gonna stay tuned in. Don't be fucking swindled by this shit. Be better than this shit. All right, thanks guys, I'm going on fucking vacation. I'm done.